Roles in Webflow are structured in a way so that you and your team can safely and securely do what you need to do. Based on your role, you'll have all the permissions you need and not the ones you don't. And we'll split this lesson into two chapters. First, we'll review where to assign roles, and then we'll talk about all the different roles and what they can do in Webflow. Let's review real quick. Before we look into each role, remember, you can choose a team member's role when you add them to your workspace in your team settings. And their seat type, full, limited, or free, determines which role they can have. You can also change a team member's role within a specific site in the site access settings. But we cover that in detail in another lesson. That's the review. Let's take a look at what each site role can do in Webflow. Here we have a graphic. Actually, that's the wrong graphic. Okay, here's the graphic, and it's showing the members of our site and their role, and which seat type they have. And we'll start with site roles that require you to have a full seat. These are typically the roles with the most capabilities. First, the site manager. That could be your design team manager, and they have a full seat. They have full access to the site settings and all of Webflow's design features. Then we have the designer role. This could be your web lead. They also have a full seat. Likely, they are responsible for building the site's design system, updating your team's library, and making sure that everything is on brand and meets your company's vision. Next, let's look at the site roles that require you to have, at a minimum, a limited seat. These roles are designed to give less technical teammates the power they need to get their jobs done, while restricting them from touching anything they don't have access to, like the design system, in order to keep the site safe. First, we have the marketer role. That could be someone like a growth marketer who wants to safely and quickly build an event or landing page by using designer-approved building blocks in a drag-and-drop environment. Then there's the content editor. This could be a copywriter who is focused on updating and editing the copy, swapping images, adding dynamic content, and helping with page SEO. And then there's the free seat. The reviewer role is the only role that can be assigned to someone with a free seat and gives that person the ability to add comments and review things. And this could be your CMO who needs to review things before the site goes live. And if you're on an enterprise plan, there's one more role to know about, and that's the custom role. Like it sounds, you can give this role just about any permissions you need for them to get the job done. And that's how seats and roles work in Webflow. Another note, so far, we've been talking about site roles, but if you have any guests in your workspace, like an agency or freelancer, they can have any of the site roles we just talked about. For even more detailed information on site roles, you can go over to the Help Center. That's it. Let's recap real quick. We reviewed various site roles. Then we covered all the different site roles and walked through an example of how a team could be structured. And finally, that's it. That's site roles in Webflow.